Today, on site with Anderson Windows, I'm Jake Bruton, and I'm going to walk you through our total performance package that my firm has chosen for this project in Columbia, Missouri. Okay, so the conversation for performance package is not just wall assembly, it's not just windows, it's not just mechanicals, it's actually all those things. Our decision-making process, we choose to think of that as one item on the line item of the budget. So we can push and pull, and the more we spend on wall assembly, insulation, windows, the less we get to spend on mechanicals, but the more we spend on our envelope, the less we need mechanicals. Our load goes down, our energy usage goes down, our comfort goes up. So let's walk through what we have here. Our control layers on the outside of the house are also part of this performance package, as it would be. The whole system starts with our zip system sheathing on the outside. We have a water and air control layer that is pinnacle. Like, it is better than just about anything you can buy on the market. We're always happy with it. It always performs for us. And it also helps with air leakage. So in this situation, we have a concrete foundation that's part of our air control layer below grade. We have zip seating on the walls, and then we have an air control layer on the ceiling upstairs that we'll talk to that gives us that continuous path all the way around for our air barrier. This air barrier also happens to be, you can see here, it's Zip R, so it has a continuous R6 polyiso insulation that is outboard of our framing. That raises the point of condensation in the wall. It gives us continuous insulation, so we get full R value out of that R6. It counts as a full R6. And then we partner that with the T-studs. Now, the T-studs serve two purposes in this wall assembly. Number one, they are a direct replacement for our 2x6 studs, but they're a thermal break the same way the Zip R is a thermal break. So we don't have that thermal bridge from inside to out because we have this space in the framing. Number two, they actually happen to be very straight. So while we get an energy upgrade out of them, we also get dead flat walls. So we're not changing to a different framing material in places where we have cabinets or intricate trim work or anything like that. We're able to just utilize one product through the whole house. That makes our framing process that much simpler. In this case, we've chosen to go with an Anderson 100 series window behind me. Again, we get multiple benefits out of that. We get a really good air seal. This house, we've already guaranteed the clients will be under one ACH 50 with the blower door when we're done. We know that we can promise that because we've delivered that with the same basic wall assembly and window package previously in our career. Actually, the very first house that I ever did a blower door test on that we had built was almost passive house levels of air leakage with the 100 series windows. Now, we make some choices. You know, the casement windows we like a little bit better for this sort of aesthetic, but I really like the way that the latch actually pulls it into the weather stripping, so we get a little better air seal out of those. The other thing that you can do is you can go to a picture window for the optimal air seal, because if it doesn't have to move, it's going to be sealed from the factory and there's no on-site adjustments or anything. From there, we start talking about air control layers upstairs. So let's run upstairs and see how we go from the very simple sheet good that's just taped on the outside to interior barrier upstairs. Okay, so now we're on the uppermost floor of the house, and there are actually three bedrooms, a like reading nook and a bathroom that go up here, but as you can tell, none of the walls are in. Well, this is a tight house. We have to be considering the envelope at all times when it comes to air control, and we're a big fan of bringing that as low as we can to the flat and then putting our insulation on the outside. So what we have here is we have the very easy to execute in 4-foot by 8-foot sheet zip sheathing on the outside and our Anderson 100 series windows, but those don't help us with the transition under our roof trusses and then our ceiling here. So what we have is we have a Sega Myrex, which is a air or vapor control layer, depending on how it's installed from Sega. It's taped to the outside of our zip sheathing. It's run to the inside. We set our trusses. Now we have the ability to connect to that flap, that flange, that piece of material there. We have a couple choices. We could either just run zip sheathing on everything here, and that would be our control layer as it is on the outside, or we can continue with the Myrex. And the reason we're gonna continue with both the Myrex and the zip is just order of operation stuff that's happening here and what our subcontractors have requested due to previous, you know, interactions with this type of system. We'll use the Sega Myrex from the heel of the truss at the edge of the wall over here, all the way over, up the vertical inside this plenum, and then we'll tape that to our zip sheathing here. The reason we have zip sheathing on the ceiling of the plenum, so it'll be inside our envelope, but outside the visible space from our clients, this plenum will hold our ductwork and our ducted mini split system. That unit only takes up about 12 inches. We have a 14 inch plenum there, and we have the ability to then frame a false ceiling underneath that. And now all of our ductwork is inside our air barrier and our insulation. We don't have a HVAC unit trying to push conditioned air through an unconditioned hot or freezing cold attic. So everything's inside the envelope. The system doesn't have to work as hard. It doesn't have to be as powerful. It doesn't have to cost as much because we've partnered it with good, deliberate building techniques, with good material choices in our zip sheathing, in our Anderson windows, in our air control layers. And all of this performance package comes to play on a modestly priced, well-built home. Thanks for joining me today from our new construction project here in Columbia, Missouri. Stay tuned for more On-Site with Anderson.